مصاحبه شهردار رودی جولیانی درباره روی کار آمدن آخوند حسن روحانی رئیس جمهور جدید ارتجا. همچنان که قبلاً به اطلاع بینندگان گرامی رسید، 13 شخصیت برجسته بین‌المللی شامل نیوت گینگریچ رئیس پیشین کنگره آمریکا و کاندیدای ریاست جمهوری در انتخابات سال 2012، دکتر آل خویدال کوادراس نایب رئیس پارلمان اروپا، شهردار رودی جولیانی، تامریج اولین وزیر امنیت آمریکا، جنرال جیمز جونز اولین مشاور امنیت ملی رئیس جمهور اوباما، جنرال جورج کیسی فرمانده پیشین نیروهای ائتلاف در عراق، ویلیام لیسی کلی نماینده کنگره آمریکا، فرماندار اد رندل رئیس پیشین حزب دموکرات آمریکا، فرانسیس تاونزن مشاور پیشین کاخ سفید، پورترگاس رئیس پیشین اطلاعات مرکزی، پاتریک کندی، اینگرید بتانکور و سناتور رابرت توریسلی طی مصاحبه‌های پیرامون انتخابات اخیر رژیم و روی کار آمدن آخوند روحانی تأکید کردند وی چیزی از قماش حاکمان قبلی رژیم ایران است. رودی جولیانی شهردار نیویورک در سال 2001، شهردار جامعه بین المللی در نیویورک، کاندیدای ریاست جمهوری. مصاحبه شهردار رودی جولیانی درباره رئیس جمهور جدید ارتجا.
Well, I think this is deja vu all over again, as Yogi Berra says. This is precisely what we thought in the late mid to late 90s, that there'd be a moderate government. President Clinton made a number of concessions, including listing the MEK as a terrorist group, which turned out to be a terrible mistake. All of this because there was a moderate group. Well, that moderate group saw to the deaths of thousands and hundreds of thousands of people, including Americans. Didn't lead to moderation. It led to getting, you know, within an inch of becoming a nuclear power. Mr. Rouhani has a background that is frightening. Mr. Rouhani was very, very close to Ayatollah Khomeini. He is the one that originally named him Imam. He sat on a National Security Council that oversaw the slaughter of thousands of people, including many Americans in Iraq. So this is a long history of anything but moderate conduct. Now, the worst of it is, of course, what he wrote himself when he says that while he was negotiating, it was really just a subterfuge for going ahead, full speed ahead with the nuclear program. Those are his own words. I mean, he wrote that himself, basically to appear to be a moderate in order to fool the foolish Westerners and then go right ahead with enhancing their nuclear capability. So I'm afraid that if we fall for these propaganda devices, that he's a moderate, we're going to fall into the same trap we've been in now for 15, 20 years. They stop negotiating. We get frightened. We negotiate some more. Meanwhile, they go full speed ahead and become a nuclear power. Mr. Rouhani has carried out that kind of program from the time he's been in public office. And of course, he couldn't have run without the blessing of the present Ayatollah Khomeini. So he was very close to the original Ayatollah. He slaughtered so many people. He is and was the representative of this present Ayatollah on the council. He was responsible for this whole program of trying to fool the West by pretending to negotiate and going ahead with nuclear power. So I would say we should be very skeptical of him and not just embrace him as some kind of moderate. Let him prove he's a moderate by halting completely the nuclear program and by restoring some degree of freedom and decency in Iran, and let him speak out about the horrible way women are treated by the Ayatollah and his government. Let's hear some very strong statements that take courage, and then maybe we can call him anything less than what he's been so far, which is a fanatic.